Hello everyone. Today we're going to continue our journey into Dataflow by taking a look at the Dataflow CLI tool, which allows you to manipulate Dataflow from the command line. First of all, let me show you where to find it. So if you have the Dataflow UI because you've installed Dataflow locally or it's elsewhere on a server somewhere, then use this link at the bottom, About and Docs, and that will tell you, first of all, where all the documentation is, even the source code if you want to take a look at that. But here, this is the bit that we're interested in, getting the Spring Cloud Dataflow shell. If you click on this link, it will offer you a download of a jar file, and you should accept that download, put that jar file somewhere locally on your path. Now, because it's a jar file, you're going to use Java to interact with it. So you must have Java available locally on your machine. And to make things simpler, I'd highly recommend that you create an alias. And that's what I've done here. If I do Dataflow, show you my alias. I've just shortened it to Dataflow. So if I type Dataflow in, I go. Okay, so the shell's booted, and the first thing you probably want to know is how to get some help. So just type help, and that will give you a list of all the commands that are available in Dataflow. It's quite a large list, so to shorten it down, just type help and then use one of the commands. So for example, app is one of the commands. If I do help app, then I get a shortened list and it tells me all the things that I can do with apps. For example, I can get a list of all the registered apps. So if I do app list, here's my list of registered applications. I can also register new applications. So let's do that now. So if I do app register, I give my app a name. In this case, I'm going to reinstall the loan source. And I can give my app a type. And in this case, it's a source. And I need to tell Dataflow where to find the Docker image. So I give it a URI and I say Docker, Ben Wilcock, and then loan source version 1.0.0. Right. There we go. I've successfully registered the application. So if I do app list once more, and there it is right at the bottom there. Can you see that? Perfect. So that's my application registered. I can also create streams just like before. So if I do stream create, I give the stream a name. So the name will be the loan log stream in this case. And I need to define the stream, and I can define the stream just using text, which is pretty handy. So definition for this is quite straightforward. I'm going to use the loan source, and then I'm going to bind that in Dataflow to the log. So there we go, it's created the new loan log stream, and I can see that if I do stream list, there it is. So it says it's been created, but it's not currently deployed. That's sort of intentional. I'm going to do that now. Now, a bit of a long command this, so forgive me if I cheat a little bit. So stream deploy, give it a name, so loan log stream. And then I need to use a whole bunch of properties. So I have those in my copy buffer already. So I'm just going to paste those in. There we go. So the properties, remember, I set in the UI previously. Here I'm doing them with text. The ones that I'm interested in are the entry point style and the image pull policy for Kubernetes. So there we go, that has now been created as a deployment. And in the background, if I switch to Kubernetes, you can see Dataflow is installing that new stream for me. let's take a look at the log for the loan source component. And we can see that it's currently starting up. As soon as it does start, it will start generating loan applications for me and sending them out via messaging onto Rabbit. And Dataflow has hooked the log component to the same Rabbit exchange. So we should start to see these loan applications coming through into our log. So let's switch to our log component and take a look. And yeah, there they are, all nice, present and correct. So that was very easy, wasn't it? And one last thing I'm going to show you is the fact that you can actually script against this CLI as well. I've prepared a script in advance. Let me just show you that by exiting the Dataflow UI for a second. If I just have a look at the undeploy script, I've created one in advance called undeploy loan log stream. Here it is. It's going to do an undeploy of the loan log stream. It's going to destroy that stream, which completely removes it from Dataflow. And then it's going to unregister the source that I was using, the loan source. So let's give that a try. So I type script. I tell it the file, which in this case is undeploy. Text. And now it's done. Very quick, very easy.